वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। हेलो,
गुड
यस, टुडे आल्सो वी आर हैविंग सम ड्रिलिंग ऑन द कोर्स 201, दैट इज क्वालिटी एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन। ओके, सो वील स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन। द क्वेश्चन इज द वर्ड मैनेजमेंट इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम डैश डैश वर्ड एंड द ऑप्शंस आर लैटिन, फ्रेंच, जापनीज, संस्कृत। सो व्हाट इज द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस?
लैटिन, फ्रेंच, 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 नेचर।
ओके ओके, सम आर सेइंग दैट लैटिन एंड सम आर सेइंग दैट फ्रेंच, बट द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज फ्रेंच। ओके, डू यू रिमेम्बर द नेम, डू यू रिमेम्बर द वर्ड विच फ्रॉम विच फ्रेंच वर्ड दिस पर्टिकुलर मैनेजमेंट वर्ड इज डिराइव्ड? यस
मैनेजिंग समथिंग।
यस यस, यू आर क्लोजर, बट द आंसर इज इट इज द मैनेजमेंट और मैनेजमेंट। ओके, सी द वर्ड, दिस वर्ड मैनेजमेंट इट इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम फ्रेंच वर्ड एंड द वर्ड्स आर, सो देर आर टू वर्ड्स एंड द मीनिंग ऑफ बोथ द वर्ड्स इट इज सेम। ओके, एंड वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट वर्ड? एक्चुअली द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस इज आर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग एंड लीडिंग। ओके, एंड द वर्ड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू रिपीट द वर्ड्स अगेन, मैनेजमेंट और मैनेजमेंट। ओके, अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन? यस। द नेक्स्ट इज
यस मैम।
द मैनेजमेंट कंसेप्ट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज एज अ, द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज नाउन, सेकेंड इज प्रोसेस, थर्ड इज डिसिप्लिन एंड द फोर्थ वन इज ऑल ऑफ द अबव। यस, नाउ टेल मी विच इज द करेक्ट आंसर।
All of the above.
वेरी नाइस, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन दिस व्हाई यू आर सिलेक्टेड दिस पर्टिकुलर, दैट इज ऑप्शन नंबर फोर?
Because it
सी
is a
बिकॉज
process. Yes, ma'am.
यस यस यस, फर्स्ट यू गिव रिप्लाई एंड वॉट एवर आंसर इज रिमेनिंग आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट। यस, so why you have selected this particular option, this management, it is a noun, it is a process and it is discipline as well. Yes,
all this process takes place only if you work it out in a disciplined manner.
See here,
and it
the
is successful.
see here this discipline is, it is not related to the rules and regulations should be followed by the person who is a part of that particular organization or the institution. Okay, here the discipline, it is nothing but the branch. Okay, because if we see there is a vast what you can say, the vast, it is a vast body of knowledge, theories, laws and practices. That's why it is also a discipline and there is a separate study of management. It is a process, because just recall all the functions of management, because always we are planning, organizing, there is a different other function, staffing, directing, coordinating, communicating. So it is a process. And what about the noun? Because there are different individuals, they are working in that organization and then they exercise this leadership. And these are, it can be principal, it can be vice principal, it can be teachers, etc. So that's the reason it is noun, it is process and it is discipline as well. So fourth option is correct, that is all of the above. Okay, understood about this? Yes, should I move ahead?
Yes,
yes, good. Okay, this is also very simple. Educational management is not theoretical but gives practical measures. Option number one, this is. Second is dynamic in function. Third is a system of authority. And the option number four is all of the above. Now tell me which is the correct one.
All
you can
of
take.
Above.
Yes, because it is not only theoretical, because it gives the practical measures. Because it is a process. Okay. It is dynamic. It is dynamic means it's not a static. Okay, there are changes in the functions, and for leading, what we can say, for implementing different things, the leadership is executed, means it is regarding the authority, means it is also a system of authority, means someone should be there as an authorized person. Again, here we are following certain hierarchy, certain levels. Okay, so option number four, that is the correct one. Yes, the next is Okay, now I'm expecting answer of this question very quickly. This is very easy question. We have practiced this question many times. Yes, the question is to manage is to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to control, and to coordinate. This definition of management is given by, yes, and the options are, the first option is Lawrence IP. The second is Peter Drucker. Third is Henry Fayol. The fourth one is Frederick Taylor. Yes, now tell me which is the correct one.
Peter. I think Peter Drucker.
Okay, any other answers?
Forecast.
Yes. Okay, so whenever, see, in the examinations also, suspect questions means the particular definition is given by whom. There may be chances of asking such types of question. Okay, so you have to study all the definitions properly, and it's really impossible, it's really challenging to remember all the definitions. So instead of remembering all the definitions, just focus on the certain words. For example, Lawrence Appy. Okay, so if we see the definitions given by the Lawrence Appy, basically he focuses on the process of development of people and the process of personal administration. So these are the two words related to the Lawrence Appy definition. Okay, then the next is the Peter Drucker. According to Peter Drucker, management itself a function and it is also discipline. So you can just remember these two words, that is itself a function and a discipline. Henry Fayol, yes. Actually the answer of this question is the Henry Fayol, and if you remember, the six functions given by the Henry Fayol, the functions are actually highlighted in this definition. And the functions given by Henry Fayol are to forecast, to plan, means the plan, forecasting, planning, organizing, commanding, controlling, and coordinating. So you can just count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total six functions are given by the Henry Fayol, and this is the definition is given by Henry Fayol. And in case of Frederick Taylor, according to Frederick Taylor, the management is the art of knowing what you want to do in the best and cheapest way. Okay, so just try to remember. So Taylor, he is focusing on the management, it is the art. In case of Lawrence, he is focusing on the process of development of a people and the personal administration. And Peter Drucker, he focuses on, he's saying that the management itself a function and it is also a tactic and discipline. Okay, so such the specifics words you should have remember. Okay, so this is about this definition. It is given by the Henry Fayol, that is option number 3. Understood this? Yes, students. I'm just giving you clue how you can remember the definitions. There is no need to, because now you are going for the MCQ examinations and it is really impossible, it is really challenging, because you are going to study so many subjects. Okay, so maybe there will be what you can see, chaos while studying all the subjects. So remember, so this is one trick. By using this, you can remember the definitions given by whom. Yes. The next is Fayol's functions of management include. The first option is planning, designating, completing, cooperating. Second is punishing, commanding, organizing, coordinating, controlling, preparing, commanding, operating, consulting, controlling. And option number 4 is planning, commanding, organizing, coordinating, and controlling. Now tell me which is the correct one. Yes. It is very simple, because already we have studied, observed all these functions given by Henry Fayol in the previous example only. The definition given by the Henry Fayol, just try to recall that definition. Yes. Yes.
Option.
Option number, yes. Which option is correct? See, let me tell you the definition is to manage means to forecast. Yes, to manage means to forecast, to plan. Then next is, yes, to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to coordinate, and control. Okay. Yes. Now, yes. Now tell me which option is correct.
Fourth option.
Yes, very nice. And I see one function is missing over here. Can you find it? Yes, that is nothing but the forecast. Yes, that is nothing but the forecasting. Okay, so total six functions are given by the Henry Fayol, the functions of management, forecasting, planning, commanding, organizing, coordinating, and controlling. So I'm going to log this answer. I'm going to highlight it. Yes, okay. Then the next question is, yes, in the levels of management, the teachers are comes under. So as you all know, there are different levels of management. So let's see the options. Option number one is lower level management. Second is middle level management. Third is higher level management. And fourth one is none of the above. Now tell me which option is correct. Yes.
Middle.
Okay, some are saying that middle. Any other answers? Okay, we will tell you. Don't worry. See, lower level managers, higher level managers, and middle level managers. So basically, the trustee member and the principal, it comes under higher level managers. The vice principal and supervisor, it comes under middle level managers, and the teachers, non-teaching staff, and if any other worker is there in that organization, working in that organization, all comes under lower level management. Okay, so here the teachers comes under, yes, which level of management?
Lower level.
Yes, the answer is lower level management. Yes, yes, this is very interesting. Dash dash is not the characteristics of educational management.
Yes, I'm not able to see the presentation.
It's what about visible. Others? Yes, it is visible. Maybe you have some. Just wait for some time. You'll be able to see, because whenever there is a problem of internet bandwidth, you may face this problem. Yes, just wait for some time. Or just you can log out and you can log in again. Yes. Okay. Okay, thank you.
Fourth one.
Yes. Wait, yes. Can you justify this? Why you have selected this option number four? Yes. Because dash dash is not the characteristics of educational management. The options are flexibility. The second is leadership. Third is efficiency, and fourth is bureaucracy. Yes.
Bureaucracy. Because for a proper management, you need a good leadership. Just a bureaucrat won't be enough, obviously.
Yes, very, very nice. See, because the educational management, there is a flexibility. Okay, then leadership, it is required for the proper management. So leadership, it is also characteristics. There should be efficiency. Can anyone tell me the meaning of efficiency? What it is? Efficiency means what?
They should handle it properly.
Efficiency means, yes.
How effective work is going, or ability to do work. Like.
Yes, yes. Ability to do work, and actually, so whatever ability the employees are having, the management should utilize to the optimum level. That is nothing but the efficiency. And bureaucracy, can you tell me about the bureaucracy? What it is?
Means only one person commands everything. It's like you have to listen to them.
Yes, it's like, yes, it's like bossing over the people. We have already studied different types of management leadership, and in that this is the fourth one, actually, which this is not in the syllabus. The meaning of this bureaucracy, that is bossing around the people. Okay, so option number four, that is odd man out, so which is not characteristics of educational management. Okay, good, very nice answer. Okay, the next question is, teacher appraisal can be given in the form of, the one is praise, the second one is promotions, third is incentive, and the fourth is all of the above. Now tell me which option is correct.
And the fourth one is
very nice, because appraisal, so it can be in the form of praising, it can be in the form of promotions, it can be in the form of incentives. So the option is, fourth option is the correct, that is all of the above. Very nice answer. Yes. Okay. Now you have to recall, what you have to recall, just, okay, I will read the question first. Allocating and arranging work to all human resources is called as, the options are leading, second is organizing, third is cooperating, and fourth one is directing. So now tell me which option is correct. Yes. Yes. The answer is very simple. You can just try elimination of the options. The options which are
organizing.
Yes, those who are giving answers leading or organizing, can you justify it? Why you have selected this particular option?
Means a leader will allocate, arrange what is to be done for the human resources. The one who is a leading quality.
Okay.
Organizing is also somewhat like that only.
Okay, see, means we have already eliminated the option number 3 and 4, which are not related to this. So you are going to select any one option from 2. Now 50-50 is here. Okay, so out of 2 you have to select one option. Just recall the different functions of management. I'm not talking about the different functions of management given by the particular theorist. The general functions of management, yes. So first is planning, then then there is organizing. So what comes under organizing? Yes. And see, if you see the leader leading, that is nothing but the leadership, and it is the leader, it is nominated, or what you can see, it is appointed to look after the group. Okay, so this is about the leadership. And what about the organizing? Organizing means what? Yes. And in simply, we can say when the particular person is having influence on the others, means influence on the followers, that is nothing but the leadership. And in case of organization, there is an organization of human resources and the material resources as well. But the mainly we are going to think about the human resources. So which option you will select for this? Allocating and arranging work to all human resources is called as. Yes, because see, leading means what? Leading, it's a process, right? It's a process of, in here the leader, here he is influencing others. Others means who? He is influencing followers. That is meaning of leading. Of course, this is a task of leader. But if you see the function of management, then there is which option you will select? Yes, because out of these two, yes, the organizing, this one, this is the correct one. Yes, very nice. Okay, the next is, educational management lays more stress on, yes, democratic, decentralization, participation, and the fourth option is all of the above.
All of the above.
Very nice. See, because it is expected that the leader is elected by using the democratic way. Because even our country is also democratic, there should be centralization. See, the decentralization. So now this word is related to what? Yes, decentralization and centralization. These are two different words. They are related to the particular thing. Can you tell me about that? So whenever we are talking about the centralization, it is related to the decision making. Okay. And the participation means whenever the decision is taken, it is not possible every time, but while taking any decision, there should be participation of other employees also. Even while completing different tasks, everyone should participate for the completion of the task. So the option number 4, it is correct, that is all of the above. Yes, very nice answer you have given. Yes, this is the simple one. Henry Fiol was born in, yes, the answers are, the options are 1841, the second is 1941, the third is 1961, and the fourth one is 1861. Now tell me the which is the correct option. Yes.
8041.
Yes, very nice. The option is 8041C. If we see the duration, means birth and date of this particular theorist, that is Henry Fayol, it is 1841 to 1925. Okay, so automatically when there is a 1945, so we are going to eliminate this particular, yes, 1945. So we are going to eliminate these three. Okay, there may be chances of elimination of the second factor also, and then you have to select only one option from two. So like this, you can use the elimination of the option. So this is also one trick. If you know the durations accordingly, after knowing that, you can select. It will be easy for you to select the option when you are solving MCQ questions like this. Okay, so here the option one is correct, that is 1841. So they may ask about the durations also. Yes, so it is 1841 to 1925, and like that they will give more options here. Yes, this question is Henry Fayol's theory is also known as, yes, Henry Fayol's theory is also known as, option number one is Fayolism. The second option is administrative management theory. The third is scientific management theory. And the fourth is option number one and two.
Now, first option.
Okay. I want any other answers? Yes, see, the correct option is option number four, that is option number one and two. Yes, this is the Fayol's theory, which is also called as Fayolism. But one more name is there, that is administrative management theory. It can be also called as administrative theory of management. Okay, so, and see, the scientific management theory, it is given by the Frederick Taylor. So we are going to eliminate this, and the option number four is correct, that is option number one and two. These are the both are the another names for the Fayol's theory, that is Fayolism and administrative management theory. It is also called as administrative theory of management. Okay, understood about this? Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Yes. Again, I am going to highlight the same definition. In which year, or in the year dash dash, Henry Fayol defined management as to manage, to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to control, to coordinate. And the options are 1916, the second option is 1816, third option is 1866, fourth option is 1966.
1916.
Third one, 1866.
Okay, 1866. Okay, you're very, what you can say, you're really brilliant, because just now I told you how to eliminate the options. So according to the, what you can say, the duration, it is the 1841, so automatically we are going to eliminate the second option. And the 1925, again, you are going to eliminate the fourth option. So now we have to select any one option from these two. And already both the answers were given by you. The correct option is 1916. In the year 1916, Henry Fayol defined management as to plan, to manage is to focus, to plan, to organize, to command, to control, and to coordinate. अभी मुझे ऐसे लग रहा है कि देखो, एक ही functions of management given by Henry Fayol, ये एक ही question है, उसको merge करके कितने सारे questions पूछे गए हैं. So you have to remember each and everything. So you have to apply certain tricks to recall or to remember the information. Okay? Yes, very nice. Yes. Now, this question is regarding the, yes, can you tell me this question is related to? Yes, it is related to principles of Henry Fayol, principles of management given by Henry Fayol. And the question is, an employee should receive instructions from his superior and should be accountable to only one superior. This Henry Fayol's principle is called as unity of direction, unity of command, order, and discipline. Yes. Now tell me which one is the correct option.
Unity of direction.
Okay, unity of direction. Yes.
Unity of direction.
Unity of direction. Very nice. Okay, any other options? Yes, no options means you are going. Should I log this answer? That is option number one. Unity of direction. Yes. See, again, what you did, you again did the same thing. You might have confusion between which option you supposed to select for this option number one and two. Because see, you should know what exactly meaning of the particular principle. So discipline, it is regarding the rules and regulations of the particular organization and should be followed by everyone who is part of that organization. Order means right person should be at the right, in case of job, the right person should be placed in the right place. That is nothing but the order. Then automatically we are going to eliminate the option number 3 and 4 and we have to select one option from this previous first two, that is unity of direction and unity of command. Okay, now you should know the meaning of unity of direction and unity of command. Okay, just go to the statement. An employee should receive instructions from his superior, means someone is given instructions. See, and who is following that instruction, that person is only accountable to that particular superior who is giving instructions. So this is related to the unity of command. The correct option is unity of command, not unity of direction. Then what is unity of direction? Yes. Why you have selected this option? Because you might be thinking that this is the meaning of unity of direction. But what may unity of direction? So those who are working in particular organization, they should have the particular plan so that they can work on that. So that particular planning is nothing but the unity of direction. It's, for example, in case of school, there is academic calendar. So that academic calendar is nothing but the action plan and everyone is following that particular direction. Okay, if as a teacher, you don't know that in the month of March, the school is going to conduct final examinations, or you can say the annual examinations, then as a teacher, it's your duty to finish your portion, finish your syllabus of your subject within time before annual examination. So that particular annual planning is giving you the direction for the completion of the task. So here we are going to log this option number two, that is unity of command. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, good. Yes. Now I'm expecting a correct answer for this question. We all believe that every department of organization should be working on the same plan to achieve the organization's goal objectives. He expressed this in which principle of management? And the options are unity of direction, order, centralization, authority. Yes, which is the correct option? Yes. Just now we have discussed about the planning. There should be some plan. So, yes.
Unity of direction.
Yes, very nice. Unity of, see, here also you can use the elimination trick because order is nothing but the right place should be. I'm getting distracting noise. Please mute yourself. Yes, order means what? The right person should be at the right place. The authority. Say authority and responsibility, they go hand in hand, they are complementary to each other. So authority, it's about the leadership and the different leader at the different level, they are having different authorities. So it is not regarding the authority. Then centralization means what? Yes, in the previous example also, you have studied that whenever there are words, please remember, whenever there are words like centralization or decentralization, they are related to the decision making process. Okay, so decision making process, it can be centralized, it can be decentralized. So whenever we are talking about the centralization, centralization means what? Yes, so decisions are taken only by the one person. It's like autocratic, we can say. Yes, so here decisions are taken by only one person. He is not taking opinions from others. Okay, so that is nothing but the centralization. So automatically we are going to eliminate these second, third and fourth option. So and option number one we are going to select as the correct option. Okay, so unit of direction means what? You can see the meaning of his. See, everyone is working on the same plan to achieve the organization objective. Some means some planning should be there, some action plan should be there. So this is meaning of unit of direction. Understood about this? Yes. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Authority and responsibility are dash dash to each other. Yes, the options are, the first option is supplementary, the second option is complementary, third option is contradictory, fourth option is none of the above. Yes.
Ma'am, it is a contradictory.
See, what is, okay, someone is saying that complementary, some are saying that contradictory. Now tell me, what are the meaning of complement, contradictory? Yes.
Contradictory means it is related to the relation, ma'am.
See, you should
if
know
the
meaning.
Given, then the person has to take the responsibility of that whatever work given, ma'am.
See, can anyone tell me the meaning of contradictory? Yes, other students also, they can try. Contradictory means, yes?
Ma'am, contradictory means it's just opposite to each other.
Yes, actually contrast, just opposite to each other. Of course, the authority, because authority and responsibility goes hand in hand. So, yeah. Of course, they are not supplementary, means the for authority, they're the responsibility is supplementary. It's not like that. Again, we are going to eliminate the supplementary. Then contradictory, are they contrast? Of course not. They are not contrast because they are going hand in hand. So here the option number, yes, because the complementary means they are going hand in hand. They are complementary to each other. So here we are going to lock which option? That is option number two, that is complementary. Understood about this? See, whenever you're going to select correct option, you should know the meaning of the particular word. So it will help you to select the correct option. Just usko tukka jaise marte na, waise aap mat karo. Theek hai? Okay. Decisions are to be taken by the higher level managers, whereas decisions should be executed by the lower level managers. Okay. This Henry Fayol's principle is called as, the first is decision making, the second is centralization in decision making, the third is decentralization in decision making, and the fourth one is discipline. Yes, now tell me which option is the correct. Please read the question carefully, because already we have discussed about this in the previous examples. Yes.
Centralization of decision.
Very nice. Who gave this answer?
Meenal Upadhyay.
Meenal. Very nice, Meenal. See, because the centralization, it is one principle given by the Henry Fayol, and according to him, the only decision is taken by only the main person. Okay, so here the decision is taken by the higher level managers, and which is executed by, which is followed by the lower level managers. Okay, so see, this is about the decision making, but in the whenever, see, option number one, that is decision making. So decision making, it can be centralized, it can be decentralized. Okay, the discipline is option number four, that is nothing but the rules and regulations. So this actually statement, it is not related to discipline. So again, we are going to eliminate option number one and option number four. Then there are two options only, centralization in decision making and decentralization is decision making. Here the decisions are taken by only particular level managers, and the same decision is followed by the, or executed by the other lower level managers. So here we are talking about the centralization process of decision making. So I'm going to log this answer, that is centralization in decision making. Very nice. Yes. Henry Fayol emphasized that an entire unit in an institution should work harmoniously as a team to achieve success. This Henry Fayol principle is called as, option number one, esprit de corps, second, equity, third, subordination of individual interest to general interest, and the fourth one is stability of tenure. Yes. Now tell me which option is the correct option. Just try to use the elimination factor. Just try to eliminate the options. So you'll get many, very less options with you. And it will be easy for you to select the correct one. Yes.
Equality.
Okay.
No, it is equity, not equality. Okay.
Okay, you're going with the second option. Yes, what about others?
My second option, equity.
Okay. Have you studied different principles of management given by the Henry Fayol? In that, there is a last principle of Henry given by the Henry Fayol. That principle is nothing but, see, equity means what? What is meaning of equity? Equity means, suppose, see, in the management, there is a hierarchy, and suppose the principal is there and he is the higher level manager and he is going to treat lower level manager. So the principal should treat all the teachers equally. Means here we can say the top level manager should treat all the teachers or whatever working under him should fairly and equally. That is meaning of equity. Okay. Then see the meaning of subordination of individual interest to general interest. This is also one principle given by the Henry Fayol. See, subordination of individual interest to general interest means don't give more value to your own benefits, but instead of giving more value for your own benefits, give value, or what we can say, you have to take care of gains and benefits of your institution. Okay. खुद के बारे में नहीं सोचना है, हमारे इंस्टीट्यूट के बारे में सोचना है जहाँ पे आप वर्क कर रहे हो. सो हियर इंटरेस्ट, खुद के बारे में इंटरेस्ट लेने के बजाय आप इंस्टीट्यूशन के बारे में सोचो, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बारे में सोचो. दैट इज नथिंग बट द सबऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल इंटरेस्ट टू जनरल इंटरेस्ट. ओके. And the third is stability of tenure. So stability of tenure means what? It is related to the job security. And when there is a job security, suppose my job is secure, so automatically those who are working in the particular organization, they are going to concentrate on their work, on their task very effectively. They are doing their task very dedicatedly. Okay. And because they are satisfied with their job, they have job security. But we see nowadays we are not having job security. So maybe because of this, some teachers, what they are thinking, so I'm not, my job is not secure, so why should I take more efforts to do particular tasks of that particular organization? So this happens. Okay. So automatically we are going to eliminate the option number four also, because this is regarding the job security. And when there is a job security, there will be the satisfaction with the job, and the person, they are working, they are giving their maximum efforts, they are taking maximum efforts, they are using their maximum abilities. That is nothing but the stability of tenure. Okay, so automatically we are going to eliminate the option number two, option number three, and option number four. And only the last option is there, and esprit de corps. This is also one principle given by the Henry Fayol, and this is a French term actually, esprit de corps. Okay, and here again, the Henry Fayol given emphasis on the entire unit. So entire unit should work together. They should work in harmony and they should work as a team. Okay. And so why this is necessary? Because see, why it is necessary? The final output, that is achievement of the success, to achieve the objectives. Okay. So this is the principle, that is nothing but the esprit de corps. Understood about this? Yes. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, this is, I think we have covered many more, many functions of these Henry Fayol's principles, not functions. The final, that is, find out odd man out. Now tell me which is the correct option for this. The first option is color chain, the second is order, the third is division of work.
Ambiguity.
And fourth is, yes, ambiguity, because yes, why you are selected this particular option?
Because first three are related to each other.
Okay, first three are related to each other. Any other answer?
Double means double. See, here also, if we see
the whatever principles are there given by the Henry Fayol, the first three options are nothing but the principles given by the Henry Fayol, the scalar chain, order and division of work. Now tell me, what do you mean by scalar chain? Scalar chain means what?
It's yes? Supervision, highest rank to lower rank.
Yes, it's not supervision. You are closer to the answer, but it's not supervision. It's nothing but the flow of communication. And according to the Henry Fayol, the flow of communication, it is a one-way process and it always go from top to the bottom. Okay, actually, according to the proper definition of communication, the communication, it is the two-way process. But according to Henry Fayol, the communication is one-way process and always it is from the higher level manager to the lower level managers. Okay, so this is about the scalar chain. The order, right place at the right person at the right place. Then division of work. So what is meaning of division of work? Yes.
Distributing the work.
Yes, distributing the work. But suppose there is a main task. The main task which is divided, it is breakdown into the smaller parts and the small tasks are assigned to the different individuals. Okay. So this is about the division of work and all these three, what you can say, principles are given by the Henry Fayol. And so we can going to eliminate, means this is, if we odd man out, then the option is ambiguity. Okay. So this is the fourth option. Okay. Understood? Whatever we have discussed today, I think we have a lot of discussions on that. See, today only I have highlighted or I asked questions, MCQ questions, only on the two topics. Have you realized it?
Yes, ma'am.
Only on the concept of management and only one theory of management, that is given by the theory of Henry Fayol. I have given only questions on the only two topics. Okay, so you'll get idea that how questions will be framed. Okay, understood everything? If you have any query, please feel free to ask. Understood each and everything? Yes, yes or no? Please be interactive.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, good.